Hello, in this program, we are understanding evaluating polynomial using Horner's method. This is a polynomial, 3x cubed minus 7x squared plus 1x minus 1. This is a polynomial, and this polynomial can be written in the Horner's method in this form. 3x minus 7x, 7 into x plus 1 into x minus 1. So this is written in the Horner's method. And now 3 is a coefficient, minus 7 is a coefficient, 1 is a coefficient, and minus 1 is a coefficient. This is a program which we are trying to understand. So enter the value of x. Now scanf, enter the x. X is a coefficient, value of x is we are trying to understand. And now enter the number of terms. Okay, the total number of terms. So in our example, we are taking 5. Okay, n is equal to 5. Now, so whenever we discuss what is the value of n, and we should be knowing that n is equal to 5 in our example. Now, enter the coefficient. So we'll enter the coefficient of a polynomial. So here, so this is the, these are the coefficients. So 3 minus 7 plus 1 minus 1 are the coefficient for this example. Okay, so in our example, we can give n any input. So while giving the coefficient. Now, this is where the for loop is accepted. For starts with 0 until n, I keeps on increasing like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it accepts the value of the coefficient. Now, then this part is the Horner's method. So solving Horner's method is this part. Okay, initially sum is equal to 0, starts with I, and I is equal to n minus 1, and reduces to value, evaluate the sum value. Okay, now let's understand this step by step. Ash include stdio.h. Ash include stdio.h is a standard input output header file. Now void main. So void represents the return type, which is there is no return type. So at that time we specify void. And now main is a function. We start with the function. Start with a function of a program. Now open braces. Okay, int I, so I, this int represents the integer, okay, I, x, n, a of 10, sum 0. So I will have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but not, it will not have 0.1, 1.1 like that. 1.1, 1.2 is a float values. Int means I will store 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. Those values it will store. Now printf enter the value of x. So we need to enter the value of x. This scanf accepts the value of x. So %d represents the address of x. So enter the value of x with the address of x. So to this address it is accepting. To this address, and the value of x is taken and it is placed in the x. So this %d represents to the address of it. Enter the number of terms. So number of terms, number of coefficients which we need to order. So it, in our example, we'll be seeing 5. So now enter the number, enter the coefficients here. So as I said, the 5 is the number of coefficients, and these are the coefficients 5, 3, 2, 4, 1. Now these coefficients are written in this form. So 5 is the first coefficient, second coefficient 3, 2, third coefficient 4, and 1. So this is the polynomial we can see. So that is 1x to the power of 4 plus 4x cube plus 2x square plus 3x plus 5. This is the coefficient. Now here, so x plus 4 into x plus 2 into x plus 3 plus 5. So this is how it is written. See here, we can see that it is the first one is x, that is x plus 4. This is separated, that is x plus 4, that is x is taken plus 4, and into x plus 2 plus 2 into x plus 3 into x plus 5. So this is how the Horner's method representation. Now while solving Horner's method, we can see here the first we are adding the x plus 4, that means the highest coefficient, that means the highest coefficient first, then the next coefficient, then the next coefficient we are adding, and the finally we are adding the last coefficient. But this is the value that we have accepted first. So that means a of 0, here I starts with 0, I is less than n, I plus plus, I starts with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so 4, Okay, it will start with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, when it is 0, we'll enter 5. When it is 1, we'll enter 3. When it is 2, we'll enter 2. When it is 4, we'll enter 1. So, A of 0 is 5, A of 1 is 3, A of 2 is 2, A of 3 is 4, A of 4 is 1. So, that is what we have understood. So, here I is equal to 0, it increments. So, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, all these values is accepted and it is stored in this form. Now, we have understood the coefficients and remember x value is 2 here. So, x value is 2. Now, the first iteration, this is how it takes. So, I is equal to 0, A of 0 is equal to 5. So, second iteration, A of I is equal to 1 and I is less than 5, I plus plus, A of 1 is equal to 3. So, 3 is placed. And this is the third iteration, I is equal to 2 and I is equal to 2 here and value is 2. So, this is a 2. And the fourth iteration, I is equal to 3 here and the value is 4. And here, the fifth iteration, I is equal to 4 and I is less than 5. So, A of 4 is equal to 1. We have stored. Now, this is the Horner's method. We have accepted the values of 0 to 4 and this is the Horner's method we are trying to solve. So, as I said, we'll solve the inner loop first. That means n is equal to 5 as we discussed. N minus 1 is equal to 4. So, I is equal to 4. So, that is I is less than or equal to 0, less than 0, I minus minus. So, this will be sum is equal to sum plus A of I into x. So, this will be A of I is equal to 4. So, I is equal to 4. What is A of I? So, A of I is equal to 4. So, A of 4. So, because it is 5 minus 1 is 4. So, A of 4 is 1. So, whatever the input we have taken, we have placed it in the opposite direction. We took an input as A of 0 is equal to 5, 1 is equal to 3, 2 is equal to 2, 3 is equal to 4 and 4 is equal to 1. But while solving, we'll take it in the opposite direction. That is A of 4 is equal to 1. So, value stored in A of 4 is 1. So, 1 is placed here. We can see here. 1 is placed here. A of 4 is 1. So, the sum initially is 0. So, 0 plus 1. So, it becomes 0 plus 1 into 2. What is 2? 2 is x. X value is 2. That is what we have taken. So, now, so 1 is placed here. 1 is placed here. Sum is 0 and into 2. Okay, and now sum is equal to 2. Sum is equal to, the sum value is 2, and then sum value is equal to sum is equal to sum plus A of 3. So A of 3 is equal to 4. So 4 is placed here. That is 4. This 4. So we are getting this 4. This 4 is placed here, and 2 is coming from the previous one. This is the sum 2 plus 4 into 2. 2 is the x value. So that is. We are getting 12. So 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 into 2 is 12. So 12 is, we have got 12 here. Okay. Now sum is equal to sum plus A of 2. That is A of 2 is, this is the A of 2. A of 2 value is given. So A of 2 is 2. That is the sum is 12. 12 plus 2 into 2. So we have, that is 12 plus 2 is 24, 24 into 2 is 28, so this is 14, 12 plus 2 is 14, 14 into 2 is 28, so we got 28. Now this sum is given as an input, so this is sum, 28 is put here, 28 into 3, A of 1 is taken, A of 1, and this is 60, sum is equal to 62. So sum is, this will stop here, but we still have A of 0, but there is no, now we take this A of 0, but we are not multiplying with 2. So sum is 62, we are taking and then we are adding this 5, that's all. We are not multiplying as we did before. So we added and then multiplied, but here we just add, no multiplication. So this is the final result of Horner's values and this is the evaluation of a polynomial using Horner's method. So this part we need to understand, this is the Horner's equation. So here I is equal to n minus 1, that is equal to 5 minus 1 is 4. It starts with 4 here and then 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. This is what? Minus minus, every time it becomes minus minus, every time it goes to the log, one time minus minus. So 4 gone, 3 again execution, 2 execution, 3 2 1 execution. So like this, sum is executed and the final result is written here. That is 62 plus 5, that becomes 67. Now we have understood the honors method completely. Thank you.